Using the expanded student data, we can do a test, a formal hypothesis test, to see if there's any difference in height between men and women. So we've seen before on the confidence interval, and we looked before on the histograms of the data. So now we can actually do hypothesis testing. So this is a hypothesis test, which is an independent sample hypothesis test. Male height is independent of female height. You could say they're possibly are not completely independent if you had siblings in the data set, but that's just a very minor point. They're actually independent sets of data, so they're not from the same individual. They're not from the same experimental unit. If we analyze, compare means, because the t-test is an example of a comparison of means, comparing the mean height for women and the mean height for men. Go to independent samples t-test, pick height as variable. Next thing you have to do is specify the grouping variable, which is going to be gender. Now we have to pick out the particular values. So here you need to check with variable view what they look like. So gender has no particular values in its string, so they're actually the words that are typed male and female. So I need to define the groups as male and female. And go continue. This is one of the advantages of coding your data. Because if I'd coded the data, I just need to put 1 and 2 or 0 and 1, whatever I got for male and female, rather than having to type the complete thing. And when you go onto bigger data sets where you've got more than two groups, you have to code the data into numbers. That's the process called ANOVA. Okay, and we have the analysis. So out of SPSS you get the first thing, tells you how many things are in each of your groups, 140 males, 519 females, what the mean value of each is, what the standard error of each of them are. The top row tells you what does first a test to see if there are equal variances, and then it applies the traditional t-test. So the traditional t-test, the degrees of freedom will be integer. It'll just be the number of data points in your data set minus 1. Now, the more advanced and more modern version of the t-test is called the Welch's corrected t-test. And that's the second row. Now, this doesn't require that the variance is the same for the two different groups. And in this case, the variance for the two different groups is not the same. So the p-value for this is less than 0.05. In this case, because the sample size is so big, it doesn't actually make any particular difference. But it is always best to use the bottom row of the table. Always use the Welch's. Never use the top row. So this simplifies the process because you can then ignore this F-test completely. You just read the bottom row. So in this case, the t-test statistic value is 12.606. It's got 183.634 degrees of freedom. This is a lot less than those from the traditional test, and you see that it's also not integer. The p-value for this test statistic is 0.00, which means it's less than 0.005. The mean difference is 0.1492 meters, so that means a mean difference of 14 centimeters. The standard error of the difference is 1.2 centimeters. And the confidence interval for the difference goes between 12.5 or 12.6 centimetres and 17.3 centimetres. I would report the confidence intervals for the difference and the p-value when you give your results. Sometimes when I'm asking for the assessment, I will ask for the test statistic. That is this particular value, 12.6. p-value is this value under the sig column, and the confidence intervals for the difference should also be reported when you're writing it up in your reports and in your final project report.